The Slovak parliament has recently passed an amendment to the Income Tax Act, which will be effective 1st January 2010. The major changes for corporate people and from the corporate income tax point of view are business combinations, new tax rules for business combinations. Another major change that might impact business people is the fact that the period for which you can claim tax losses or for which you can credit tax losses was extended from 5 years to 7 years. So if tax losses are generated after 1st January 2010, you can claim or credit them for the carry forward them for the next 7 years. The third major change is that the thin capitalization rules that should have been effective from 1st January 2010 were abolished, so people are not or shouldn't be afraid anymore about financing of their Slovak companies. Well, and then the first and the biggest change is the changes in the treatment of business combinations. The Income Tax Act now more precisely tells the taxpayers how to treat, from a tax point of view, the business combinations. More precisely, it's the sale and purchase of businesses, contributions in kind, and mergers and demergers. This applies to transactions within Slovakia, but the Income Tax Act also states some rules for cross-border transactions within the European Union. The major change was changed to the previous Income Tax Act is the fact that for mergers, demergers, and for contributions in kind, the taxpayers can choose between two tax treatments. The one is that they will treat the transactions at fair values, where there are also connected some administrative tax with it. So there is a possibility of a tax step up, which was not possible before. Or the second option, how to treat these transactions, is that they can treat the transaction at the historical values. This has also very administrative burdensome implications for both parties relating to transactions. So it's up to the taxpayer to decide which of the two options he chooses in these specific cases. One, both have advantages and disadvantages. He can save some cash flow, but on the other hand, he might have also some admin burden for the next 10 years, which is worthwhile to decide on the taxpayer which possibility he chooses.